apart from that of what you are getting from outside, there is a natural, parallel, intuitive, inbuilt, which has a resemblance of what you are saying now, what you are saying now, what you are reading now. Whatever you say, whatever you see, it has already an inbuilt pre-configured system inside, and whatever you get from outside is a reminder. And this type of getting this knowledge is known as revelation. Just as the coverage of various other murky sheets of mud is revealed while digging, whenever a person is going on for the process of digging, the murky cover of the earth's crust is removed so that the water that is already hidden inside is revealed. Like that in polishing of a gem also, the luster, the resplendence that is hidden there already, that is being revealed by a polishing process. So nothing that which is not existing is going to be revealed by means of a process. Each and every process, according to science, it is an addition. According to spirituality, it is a revelation. It is a reminder of what you have gone already with in your imprints, in your instinctive drive, in the time immemorial incorporation of the spiritual infinite resplendence of divine consciousness, which is embedded inside you inseparably. It is a natural drilling process. Number one, each and everything is brought only by exercise. Even you possess something, you have to go for exercise. That particular exercise that we are going to do, that creates a person's knowledge depending upon the tools that he takes. It may be a string, it may be a spring, it may be a stream, it may be a flow, it may be a flood. In despite of each and everybody's movements, still a person is having a balance. On the basis of the balance, the tools and the other guiding elements, he can get any amount of knowledge. This starts with observation. We also observe the same thing which Newton observed. We are also observing the same thing that Jagadish Chandra Bose has observed. But that was attentive observation, intensive observation, incessant observation, correlative observation, formative and formulative observation, and depictive and executive administration by which his imagination or his observation has been brought into a proper way. So this observation which comes from science, why I am saying this thing is, these things, how science manifests. See, scientists can make innumerable things, but only spiritual wisdom can make proper scientists, real scientists with a long run vision. So I am now teaching you the process of incubating scientists, not scientists incubating products which are not having proper long run. They are just adversities hidden in the disguise. It is just like Ravana having come in the form of a sannyasi in Srimad Ramayana. All of these new inventions, they are menace, disaster, and the total disorderly abnormality of the society has come in the disguise of benefiting the society. To clarify this, to put your real concrete structure for that, in order to bring the realistic, eternal and perennial source of supply of happiness, health and harmony, which are all the real essential fruits of the society, we need a spiritual background. That's why I'm saying this observation, unless it is guided by a proper way of a potential channel of a divine resplendence or the splendor of the clemential and potential shower of the ultimate spirit, who is an embodiment of immaculate consciousness, it is not easily possible for any person to imagine even about the true and fruitful wisdom. So here I want to say, just a regular process of observation resulting in comprehension, comprehension resulting in analytical study, then scrutiny, vision, broadening the vision, deepening the vision, which will result in hypothesis, thesis, antithesis, synthesis, concept theory, science, engineering and technology. This is the hierarchy of evolution of knowledge in epistemology in the scientific domain. This should be properly guided by a parallel flux energy, a pivotical energy which is known as spiritual blessing. On this basis, there are three sciences. One is the subtle science, and second is the structural science or super science. Third thing is known as the salient science. What is subtle science? That deals with your liberation, deals with personal identification, deals with your own happiness, tranquility, living peacefully with everybody, and resulting as a total survival of the wholesome society in bliss and eudaimonic endeavor. That is known as subtle science. Second thing is salient science, which deals with biology, which deals with astronomy, astrophysics, evolutionary cybernetics, neurology, pathology, innumerable sciences, everything which has clearly told by somebody as apology, all other ologies, they have a common name. Just as we have innumerable parts inside the body, but there is a common name known as the body. Whatever may be the innumerable parts are there, inner past, innermost past, then outer parts, innumerable parts are there, they have a composite name known as body. All the ologies have a common ology, common name known as apology. That is the composite nomenclature of all sciences. So these sciences that deals with various other things of mechanics, mechatronics, electronics, metametallurgy, innumerable divisions of sciences, they are all known as salient sciences. Special sciences are sciences that are dealing with economy, political engineering, social engineering, cultural studies, anthropology, interreligious harmony, interfaith dialogue, intercultural cross-cultural relations. So these sciences, they have to unite and work with together. It is a Trimurti. It is a Trimurti Tattva of sciences. Wherever you see science, it should be cooperative and coordinative. There should be a triangular mutual understanding and mutual execution that lies between the subtle sciences, salient sciences, and special sciences. So everything is understood by your mind. Everything is understood by you. So unless you know who you are, what is your understanding everything else? So the science of mind. Number one, which has understood everything? Mind. Which is going to promote everything? Mind. Which is going to properly use everything? Mind. Which is not going to use it properly? Mind. Which is going to destruct everything? Mind. Who is going to prevent the destruction? Mind. So everything is mind. If the science of mind is not read, if the application of mind by means of a theo-psychological or a theo-anto-psychophysiological coordination, this quadrilateral identity is not understood, the study of any other science is futile. It is sarvam hutam bhasmani. It has no use at all. So here only we want to say, what is the contribution of the Indian literature to the modern trend exclusively, irrespective of the person's caste, clan, originality, linguistic and various other barriers. So this is where we are going to end. So mind has two abilities. One is intellectual ability, second is ethical ability. Both should be there. Intellectual ability is the capability of a person to know, analyze, to deepen, to forward, to formulate, to synthesize, to apply, to distribute. Everything is intellectual ability. To give, to share with people, to enjoy, to see others, sorrows and to be sorrowful, that empathy and sympathy, everything is on the basis of ethical ability. They should go together in a rail of a train. They are parallel and they should be just going on very parallel. It is very essential. These both of the abilities should be there. This ethical ability that prevents four things. Why there is problem? Not because of intellectual ability. Not because of intellectual ability we are suffering. We are more suffering because of lack of ethical ability. Ethical ability deals with four things. Number one, non-distribution. Second thing is distribution. Third thing is discrimination. That is also that. Discrimination is a problem. Fourth thing is the destruction. Number one, what is distribution? Wealth is meant for distributing to everybody. You are not distributing it. It is held on by somebody else. That is the reason for the recession. I have attended and organized 3 seminars on recession. Special economic zones and IT administration. Recession is not due to lack of funds or due to paucity of wealth. It is due to the obesity of wealth which is unorganized, inflammating the society. Over wealth only results in recession, not to lack of wealth. It is being stagnant in somebody else's private sanctum sanctorum. It should be brought out. So, wealth is meant for distribution. You are not distributing it. That is non-distribution. Second thing is, you should prevent poverty, unemployment, other things. You are distributing it everywhere. So, preventables are distributed, distributables are prevented. What is that? It is ethical fallibility. It is ethical imprecision. We have to overrule that. Third thing is destruction. Everything is used whenever it gets into power blocks. All agents who are non-state reactors, it goes for destruction of the society. Fourth thing is discrimination in gender, race, and various other conflicts of the society. So, these two types of ability, we have to concentrate only on the Vedas. But everybody is saying to concentrate on Vedas. What is the next step? See, whenever you want to eat something, immediately you purchase the product, clean them, then put it to your proper usage and methodology of cookery, then taste the pudding. But whenever you talk about something in spiritualism, it is just like a pudding that is seen in photos or that is seen in video movies. So it becomes just something which is in a recreative experiment, not as a product which is to be experienced. So that is the problem with that. We have to institutionalize that and create that system. So first model theory is the theory of the Vedas. What is first model theory? There are 3 model theories. One is pre-operative model, second is post-operative model, third is parallel model. Pre-operative model, they say that before getting into intellectual ability, you should be very careful. After becoming intellectual, nobody will be interested in ethics. So you create a foundation of ethics, then give him the knowledge of intellectual expansion. That is pre-operative. Second thing is, you know that, now you know when to take. Whenever you put something in the oil, you know the exact time of taking. Even if you delay or a pre-checking, advanced taking, will spoil the taste or the nutrition of the substance. Like that, we must be very clear about the timing, the periodicity, the tenure, the inclination and proclivity of each and everybody who is to be subjected to our knowledge. dispersion or transmission or dispersion, they should be very properly selected. Parallel thing is, you have to simultaneously feed, just as a coffee chicory blend, you have to simultaneously feed them with ethical and intellectual abilities.